Don't really know what the point of that intro was. But anyways, Tai Lopez, he's a genius. And I know everybody watching this video absolutely agrees. And he's unanimously, everybody loves this guy. Nobody disagrees about him ever. And so that's why I'm making this video. But on a serious note, guys, what I want to do in this video is outline three things that have made me a shit ton of money from this guy. Just watching what he's done. And this is not an affiliated video for him. I'm not promoting any of his courses. In fact, I've never bought anything from him. What has made me the most money, what Tai Lopez has done that's made me the most money, is watching how he uses marketing channels. And as a marketing person, marketing channel, entrepreneurship channel, I feel you guys need to see these things too. Because I think you need to watch them. Because if you watch these things, you're going to have such an edge for the next couple years in marketing and making money. And if you don't watch these things and you stay in like, on a serious note, a lot of people are like, oh, he's an idiot and everything he does is stupid. And that's really bad because if you don't watch these things that are being done, I'm not saying he's the creator of all these tactics, but you're going to see a lot. You're going to see a lot of influencers and a lot of people using these in the next year and a lot of businesses. And if you're not doing those things, you're going to be extinct. Specifically, the last point I'm going to make in this video, if you're not applying this right now, it makes me weep. It makes me cry. Okay. So let's talk about three things he's done that I think are just insanely smart that have helped me a whole lot. Number one thing he's been doing a whole lot, and the thing he's been doing from the very beginning, or at least when he started to blow up, is seeing where platforms are going to go. Seeing where you can get in and the path of least resistance. And so if you watched YouTube way back in the day, you might have remembered Mike Chang. He was all over the ads, all over the place. You couldn't get away from this guy flexing his six-pack, showing his eating habits and stuff like that. And you might have noticed Tai did essentially the same thing on like a 10x grander scale. And by pinpointing this kind of ad source that not many people knew about, he was one of the first people really hammering it hard. What he was able to do is build up so much exposure and such a following that he was able to go out. You see like Tony Robbins, you see Gary Vaynerchuk, you see Grant Cardone, you see all these big names in business and self-help. And it's taken them decades to build up the followings they have. Tai was able to go in 2 years and do the same exact thing. And so the first thing I think you need to be taking away from this guy and what you need to be watching is whenever he starts running ads places, whenever he starts doing anything on any different type of platform, a lot of times when he starts doing stuff, you're kind of like, what the fuck is he doing that? What's the point of this shit? And then you're going to notice about a year later, it pays off big time. And so the first thing you need to be really looking at is a lot of people look at stuff like Bitcoin. You're like, oh man. If you got in 3 years ago, you'd be fucking loaded. Well, guess what? If you got on YouTube ads 5 years ago, you'd be fucking loaded right now. If you were one of the first people on Instagram and you really hammered that shit and you figured it out first, you'd be fucking loaded right now. And so watch that shit. Watch it. Number two, this is huge. So many people get stopped from negative feedback. This is one of the number one things I see a lot of people don't go all out with their business is because they're afraid of negative feedback and they take themselves too fucking seriously. They take failure too fucking seriously. And one of the coolest things I've seen him do, for example, you ever see that H3 video where he lays out the conspiracy about renting his house and being an unwashed, dirty ball sack or an unwashed, dirty penis? If that were me back in the day, I'd be a little pissed off about that. I don't think I'd be able to laugh about that too much. But one thing you see a lot of beginner entrepreneurs and a lot of beginner businesses do is they take themselves so fucking serious and they get offended a lot, a whole lot. Some of the proudest people I know are some of the most mediocre business owners I've ever seen. And some of the most humble slash I'm not going to get so fucking bent out of shape about this people are the most successful ones. And so if you notice, what Tai did is he took all this negative criticism. You can see like a video of him debating a hater or him going and having H3 come to his house or going on the show. He was able to leverage all this hate and then use that to get even more publicity, more exposure. So number two, what I'm saying right now is whenever you have a chance to leverage stuff, don't let negative criticism stop what you're doing. And also find ways to leverage that negative criticism to springboard you forward. And then the final thing I think you need to be taking away right now, especially if you're marketing, this is the big, big ass tip. And this is what you need to be in 2018. This is just my general marketing tip from what I've seen. So one of the things I gotta tip my hat to him about is 5 years ago, the only way you really could communicate with your customers was email. Okay, there's a few other ways. You get them liking you on Facebook and stuff like that. But really all it came down to is you gather people's emails, maybe their phone numbers, and you'd contact them. And what you see a lot of marketers still trying to do is that exact business model. I'm not saying email marketing is dead. It's not. But there's about 10 different ways to contact your customers. And what they've mastered, and what you actually see Grant Cardone and Gary Vee doing a really, really good job of, and so this is kind of a broad thing that I see Ty doing really well, but I see a lot of other people doing really well, is you need to know right now that if you are not interacting with your customer, you're not interacting with a person every single day or multiple times a day, you're not going to survive. You're not going to be the best at what you do. I really want you to turn on your phone or whatever right now. When you turn your phone, first thing you see, probably Ty Lopez, Gary Vee, or Grant Cardone on Instagram. Go through your snaps. What are you going to see? Them on Snap and Instagram. Then you turn on YouTube. Oh, there's a new video from one of these dudes. And then you get on Facebook. Oh, there's a new video floating around. There's a sponsored ad being shot to you, giving you some content. If you're a person right now, let's take Ty of it. Say your competition is Grant Cardone, and all you do is sales training, and you're only talking through email marketing, your customer's not going to remember you. You're done. And the even cooler thing that I think he really started, or I've seen, at least in the marketing niche, is using lives super effectively. Look, what most people would do back in the day, or they still do, they still try and do, is they create a webinar, and they try and get people to sign up for it, and then they get people on a webinar. I'm going to tell you right now, if I get 1,000 people on a webinar, and that's the max room limit, I'm going to do about $100,000, $200,000 in sales 90% of the time, unless I shit my pants on the call. And I will still do 30,000 if I shit my pants. I will even announce it next call if I do that. Just middle of the call, I'm talking like, all right, guys, and so this is what you have right now. Here's it. Uh-oh. Anyways, what I've been doing lately, what you see him doing really well, is when he goes live on Instagram. He goes live on Facebook. He goes live on YouTube. All simultaneously. The result is probably 3,000 to 10,000 people coming on and watching that. Now take my numbers that I just talked about from webinars and apply that to 10,000 people. It's a lot of sales. It's a whole lot of sales. And so one thing you need to be doing with your marketing right now that I don't see a lot of people doing is you need to be building up your Instagram following. You need to be building up your YouTube following. You need to be building up Facebook audiences, your fan pages, everything like that. So when you go live, you actually have people doing it. Because look, webinars, they're dying out. They're dying out. The old-fashioned webinars are dying out. I'm just going to straight up tell you that. But lives are booming right now. And if you apply these three tactics right here, you get in the platforms early, you don't let negative feedback stop you, and you start abusing lives and how these platforms are pushing lives, you're going to be on the cutting edge of marketing for 2018 and probably most of 2019. So those are three things I think you should apply. And if you want to start building your social media following and stuff like that, I've actually gotten linked to a YouTube guide below that shows how I built up my channel, how I get views on YouTube. There's nothing even being sold to you in that. So that's the video for today. If you like this kind of stuff, be sure to subscribe. And what I'm going to do is we're going to pick the top three comments. Here's the winners from the last video. Okay, here's the winners from the last video. What we're also going to do is we're also going to give you the $2,000 worth of courses. We're also going to send you the new Market Hero Defect hoodies that are pretty dang cool. This is like the first version. They're actually going to look even better than this. But you comment below. Actually, I'll pick five people in this video. And if you go and comment, I'll pick five people, and I'll actually directly send you one of these new hoodies. They're pretty cool. I should have pitched them a little bit more. Damn it. Don't you worry. The time will come when we open the store. So this has been today's video. Go check out that YouTube video. I'll also link below to a few more social media building videos to help you out. And that's the video for today. Take it easy.